Sarah from Average Betty here, and I'm making hash brown Benedict. This is not your weekday breakfast, people. You can't eat this in the car on your way to the office. This is a sit down and savor, special occasion, throw calories to the wind, pop a bottle of bubbly kind of breakfast. This is a breakfast fit for royalty. Let them eat hash brown Benedict. I've got an Idaho russet here. It's a small one, about 5 ounces. Carefully shred the potato and form it into 2 round hash patty shapes. I use my spatula to pick up the shredded potato shapes and transfer directly to a hot oiled pan. If you can work quickly enough and get the shredded potato into the pan, you don't need to worry about rinsing your potato shreds, and the remaining starch will help your hash patties stay together better. Come together right now in my pan. Season with some salt before flipping, and anything else you'd like. Some Parmesan cheese can make for an extra yummy hash brown. Or if you're feeling spicy, maybe a little cayenne pepper. Flip them around until they're golden and crispy. To keep these warm and crisp, pop into a 250 degree oven until you're ready to assemble your dish. Next, I'm gonna brown some Canadian bacon. You can also do spinach for eggs Florentine or smoked salmon for eggs Hemingway. The possibilities are endless. Now for the hollandaise. This is your captain speaking. Please remain calm. Hollandaise is one of the 5 French mother sauces, and if you're successful here, you'll earn yourself another Le Cordon Betty Culinary School credit, in addition to a killer breakfast. I've got some water in a saucepan here. You don't want it boiling, just simmering. To make a double boiler, I'm going to use this fancy stainless bowl and set it on top of my saucepan. Of course, if you have a legit double boiler, use it. Here are a couple of egg yolks, a little bit of water, and some lemon juice. Begin whisking and add some butter. Keep whisking and watch your temperature. If your water is too hot, you're in danger of scrambling your eggs. And if you scramble your eggs, it'll become a mother sauce. You smell what I'm cooking here? Keep whisking and add some more butter. See why this is a special occasion breakfast? Make sure to get around the sides of the bowl and keep whisking. See how silky it's become? At this point, turn off the heat, or you can even take it off the heat if you like. I like to finish with just a little more lemon juice and a couple of glugs of hot sauce. Get that good and combined, and you've just earned your Le Cordon Betty Culinary School credit. Fancy! Now to poach some eggs. And I'm not gonna lie, this can be a little intimidating too. And there are about as many egg poaching methods as there are paparazzi in Hollywood. But this is what works for me. I've got a few inches of water simmering, and this is some rice vinegar. You can use any kind of clear vinegar you like. For best results, you want to use super fresh eggs. I bought these at the market this morning, but supermarket eggs certainly aren't chicken coop fresh. But I'm Average Betty, not Martha Stewart, okay? If these were more fresh, my water wouldn't be turning white like it is right now. But don't worry, there are good things going on in there. Use a slotted spoon to move the eggs around to prevent them from sticking to the bottom of the pan, and push the egg white onto the yolk. Not that you can see what you're doing. It just makes egg poaching more like a carnival game of skill. For a runny poached egg, you want about 4 minutes. For a little more setup, you want about 5. But poach away, they're your eggs. There, that looks about good. Be honest, you totally thought this was going to be a disaster, didn't you? You need to have more faith. We've got all the components together. Let's assemble our hash brown Benedict. Here's our crispy and golden hash brown, our browned and warm Canadian bacon. Oh, Canada! The very beautiful poached egg, the very decadent hollandaise sauce, and I like a little bit of parsley on top. Let's cut into this baby. We got a gusher here. Get the hash brown Benedict recipe and more tips for a royal breakfast at averagebetty.com. I hope you give this hash brown Benedict a try. After all, it's not often you get to feel like royalty in your own home. Well, minus the servants to do all of these dishes. Find me on Facebook and Twitter and drop by my home at averagebetty.com. Thanks for watching and subscribing. See you next time. Mm-hmm. good to be the queen.